Well, this program's in really good shape, and we're doing a lot of things right. So, you know, a lot of things are going to stay the same. What we, you know, the type of student athletes we're recruiting, the accountability we have across our program, the, you know, what we expect of our guys in the classroom and on the court will stay the same. But as head coach here, you know, I will continue to make this a community team, to make this Vermont's team, to have discipline, to have teamwork, to have unselfishness, and all those things. And I'm a big communicator, and our guys are going to be have great lines of communication. And I hope these kids, after 4 years, have the best student athlete experience they possibly can have. John.
Hey John, the style of play on the court, is it going to be different, the same as it was the last 5 years under Mike Lonergan and as you as an assistant? Are you going to tweak it, or have you thought about that?
Oh, yeah, a lot. we're still going to play defense and rebound like we did under Mike, and that's going to be the backbone of what our emphasis will be here. Offensively, we'll keep initially we'll start with a lot of the same sets and stuff like that. But as we move forward, we will start to tweak things and add my own wrinkles and be a little bit more you know, a little more read and react on offense, a little more motion, high-low motion, and stuff like that, stuff that I've done as a head coach that I'm comfortable with. But I want to make sure we have continuity. I think the opportunity of hiring an assistant is it provides continuity, and we want to make sure we take advantage of that. So, you know, with the continuity with players and recruits, but also with the system. Guys understand the terminology. They understand, obviously, the plays and the system. So we want to make sure we can hit the ground running a little bit and not be blowing it up and starting from scratch. So we'll keep things the same, but with an eye and an idea that we'll change things. And by the end of the year, maybe it'll look a little bit more like I envision it. But that's the plan right now.
Bob, to kind of go off what he just said, and a phrase that you both used numerous times during this is continuing the process forward. And how important, when you came to making the final decision, was continuity, not only in staff or in philosophy, but with with some of those most likely to keep the players intact, keep the recruits intact? How big a factor did that continuity play in the decision-making process?
Well, as I said at the beginning, that really was our focus from the start, was how do we best continue the success and build on that for even greater success in the future. So that was a theme throughout the entire process. And obviously when you have a candidate who has been part of the success, that really does provide you with a level of comfort that this is someone who is going to be able to do that. And when you looked at all of the other qualities and characteristics and background that John brought to the table, it really did become a very clear decision for us that this was a person, one, this was a person that we wanted in our department, and this was a person who clearly could ensure that the success of the program continues.
To sort of follow up on that, Bob or John, what's the status of the current roster? Are all the players coming back, the recruits coming in? Have there been any releases
or anything
like that?
I'll let Coach Becker answer that one, but certainly my understanding is that things are intact as they were.
Yeah, and I've spoke with all the players and recruits, and I expect to have everyone back next year. So that's our expectation. I'm optimistic that's going to happen.
John, what's the value? I mean, you spent 5 years with the program. Do you see tremendous value in having the ability to recruit here to sort of sell the school, this program? Do you see that as an advantage as you're starting your head coaching career off somewhere else?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I think that's a big thing. I mean, I've proven that, I can recruit here. And you got to make sure it's the right fit here at Vermont. This is a special place. We have high academic standards. We expect a lot out of our guys, and we fit is a big thing. And understanding what qualities recruits need to be successful at to play at University of Vermont, but also to be successful in the classroom at the University of Vermont. And so, that is a big advantage. And we're going to hit the ground running here recruiting, and it is a process. And I think we've been really efficient in our recruiting up here. We really have been able to identify good fits for University of Vermont, and been able to hone in on those guys and get them. And so we will continue to do that. And I think that is a huge bonus on being elevated here to head coach.
What challenges do you see in this new role? In other words, is your relationship with your players going to change? Is that going to be a concern? How do you approach that aspect?
Well, that's the biggest challenge right now. I go from assistant coach to head coach, and now I'm the I'm calling the shots, and I got to be the bad guy now. And I understand that. I've done it once before, and it's gonna the good thing is we have a great group of guys and very mature guys that understand that. But there's gonna be times where they're gonna look at me like, who's this? Where is this coming from? And I understand that, and that's going to be part of the process. But I know that'll be a hurdle that will be easily cleared. But we're gonna they'll be shocked a few times, the first couple times they're wondering where this is coming from. But I'm looking forward to that. But that is the biggest challenge. That's the biggest challenge when you go from assistant coach to head coach at the same school. If you go to another place, you can kind of put your, they don't know you, and you can kind of just jump right in with your philosophies and your vision and culture. But there's going to be a culture change here, and some of the stuff they'll like, and some of the stuff they'll have to get used to. So.
Do you think